Hello, my Bill for Thousand Nation. How's everyone doing today? Hopefully everyone's having a great day. If not, I hope it gets better from here. We are back with another watcher. This one is titled Uncovering the Alien Encounters of the U.S. Government. I'm excited. Fucking aliens, Bigfoot. Yeah. Let's go ahead and get in today's story. Go ahead, turn them lights down low. Put on something comfy, come up with something special. Let's get mysterious. Yeah. Aliens.
You can't trust what these people say. They lie to us all the time. Ships that would hover with no apparent means of lift.
No, you're okay. Hey.
Welcome to Mystery Files, where we take a deep dive into cases that span from the creepy to the truly bizarre and everything in between. I'm Ryan, and today I'll be forcing my colleague Shane to hear all about the shady U.S. government cover-up of you know it and love it, unidentified flying objects, aka UFOs, or as the government now calls them, UAPs. And in the end, you'll have to decide if the mystery is solved or if it's simply a mystery.
Oh, it's aliens. It's always aliens, bro. I wonder if aliens have, like, their own version of Bigfoot.
Exciting.
You heard about this? You seen this?
I haven't followed a lot of this because I think it's very boring.
Do you think alien fly ships?
Yeah.
Oh, I was not expecting you to say yeah to that. Did you hear that at home? Everyone, Shaniacs around the world are scuttling behind bushes. Like, what?
I've never said I don't think alien fly ship.
You have said that, though.
Oh.
That's why I'm saying, are you pranking me right now?
No, I think that
would actually be a really good prank.
I think that the likely case is that we'll encounter some sort of boring bacteria or something.
I'm so confused right now. I don't know how to proceed. I was not expecting that answer from you.
Keep going with your little fucking thing, you know?
If that's who you are, then who?
You're Ryan Bergara, you believe in ghosts. I'm Shane Bidet, and I don't. No, you're okay. Hey, buddy, hey, ghosts are bullshit. Wait, Ryan, look at me. Ghosts are bullshit, and you're a dumb guy for believing in them.
Thank God. He's back. Okay. I'm back. Oh, let's get into it. I forgot almost. I was so flustered, I forgot I have my videotape. Y'all want to see my videotape?
Yeah, sure.
Hello, I'm Professor Morris Ashley. I'm a professor of extreme science by day and a hot, wild man by night. You've probably already noticed that
God.
I have incredibly brown eyes. I was once kicked in the noggin by an inky black mare. I'm looking for love, certainly. Just don't tell my estranged Italian wife, Bianca Sofia, or she'll have her neighbor Rocco put the screws on me to move back to Sorrento. He's the strongest man I've ever met. One time I saw him dig a big hole very fast, and he only sweated a little. What am I working on now? Well, I've got a lot of free time now that I'm back in Tinseltown, so until that phone rings and I get called up to the big leagues, I'm playing my own mobile games with today's episode sponsor, Mistplay. Mistplay is a loyalty app for gamers like me. So whether you're looking for a little help covering your roses, jazz tickets, or two glasses of champagne in a bubble bath, with Mistplay, you can earn rewards simply by discovering and playing mobile games. I've always been really interested in co-ed bubble baths. I'm looking for someone who will make me so giddy that I break out in hives, and who is very playful. Do you love adventure games like Alien Invasion? Word games like Word Collect? And my favorite in Mistplay's huge catalog of games, the musical game Ensemble Stars. How does it work, you ask? Well, just find games you're interested, earn points by playing, and your loyalty points can be redeemed for gift cards from Amazon, Walmart, Visa, and more. The more you play, the more points you earn. Did you know that over $100 million in gift cards have already been redeemed? Basically, I'm very lonely here in Hollywood, and I miss the rolling hillsides of Italy, and what I'm looking for is anyone who will visit misplay.com/watcher or click the link in the description to download Misplay for free. You'll get 200 bonus points for signing up today, plus use my code, WATCHER100, inside the app for an additional 100 free points, which will help towards redeeming your first gift card. See the description for all the details. Are you a human being who can make a mean tortellini ombrodo just like my Italian wife, Bianca Sofia? Do you like books that contain photos of volcanoes? Are you deathly afraid of horses? And most importantly, would you like to kick back to some smoky jazz while gaming with me? If so, give me a call.
It's pretty good, huh? It's pretty good.
That's nice.
That was
awful. I wonder who puts those videos there every week. Phoenix, Arizona, March 13th, 1997, from 7:30 p.m. to 10:30 p.m. Reports pour in as thousands of people look into the night sky, only to be shocked by what they are witnessing. Let's take a look at a video taken that night. Can we have the lights off, please? Thank you.
Woo! There's another one!
I got that one on video.
I got that one on video.
Another one just showed up.
Whoa! I can't see how this works. How does this
work? Holy shit. That's weird. They're lined up in a pattern, man. There's geometry behind this.
Yeah. What do they look like? Is it like their spear before?
Yeah, they're spears now.
They're spears now.
Yeah, they just transformed into circles right now.
So where'd
right
you get your protractor?
Now they're not spears. No, the one in the middle is dropping slightly, and it's a... Ooh, the one on the right's blinking.
What do you think?
Here's the thing. I'm not that interested in mysteries or the unknown.
He says with an M over his nipples.
It's
like Batman saying, I'm not really interested in crimes. You're dressed like Batman. The government claimed that the groups of lights were from a group of A-10 Thunderbolt II aircraft returning from a pilot training program. So, you know, they're gonna give their little tale. It's just like you can't trust what these people say. They
not at all,
all
bro.
Time. Specifically about aliens, and they're
ever don't else, believe Ryan? What they
Actually,
ever
I'm
say.
Just thinking, is that the only thing the government has admitted they lied about?
I think stuff gets declassified after a time, but I think it's after a lot of people have died, you know.
But when it's declassified, it's
like why do we know? Why should we know about all the shady shit that was going on at the Bay of Pigs? They fessed up to some stuff, you know.
Yeah, that's true. New York City, October 13th, 2010. At 1:30 p.m., calls began to flood the NYPD and the FAA phone lines with sightings of UFOs. Let's play the video of a curious incident in the sky.
What's everybody looking at?
So what is it? What we're looking at?
Oh, police are gonna go arrest them. Gonna go arrest the aliens. Oh, more lights. Uh-oh. Well, you can see here, now look what we got. Looks like we have one video, or one little. Then we have two, three, four, five. I don't know how we can't think this is an invasion.
Oh, yeah, it's a home run. That's a slam dunk.
Uh-oh. A sixth one. A seventh one? This person doesn't even care. They're just trying to get home on their bike.
That's me.
That's you, just like...
Tag yourself.
That's you listening to a podcast, like...
Yeah.
Thoughts on that?
Cool, yeah. I don't think this is a thrilling video, but talk to me about it.
But, you know, there's things in the sky. We don't know what they are.
Yeah.
Well, I guess we'll
see. It'd be weird for UFOs to be like, all right, let's pop in, and then just seven of them just sort of hovering for
right.
a while.
I still maintain the idea that aliens... They probably have the smart version of them, and they probably have idiots among their society. Sure. And then there's idiots flying around, forgetting to turn off their cloaking thing. They just left it.
Yeah.
And they're just kind of like floating, like, look at all them down there. They can't even see us. FAA spokesman Jim Peters gave a statement saying,
you know, I have never thought about, what if the aliens are dumb? I mean, he's got a point. Not every doctor graduates top of his class. Not every lawyer graduates top of their class. Like, you're going to have that idiot out there. Oh, damn.
saying that while some were suggesting the UFOs were weather balloons, his agency had not been notified of any launches. So, actually no explanation for those bad boys.
But I mean, they look like balloons.
I mean, seven? Seven weather balloons in a cluster?
It's one of that old, you know, wouldn't it be fun to believe it was UFOs? Yes. But also, you gotta sometimes just think about what is more likely, which is less sexy and fun, but...
I mean, it's actually much more fun for it to be weather balloons.
You think that's more fun than a UFO?
Yeah, because I don't want a fucking UFO flying over
Why
me.
Why not? What if they're harmless?
Didn't Carl Sagan say that if UFOs ever, or intelligent life ever came to visit Earth from a different galaxy, it would not be good?
What does he know?
He's one of the most respected scientific minds of all time. I'm surprised. Don't you, like, masturbate to his photo or something? 29 Palms, California, April 2021. At the Marine Corps Air Ground Combat Center, 50 people, including Marines.
Yeah, if they show up, it can only go one of two ways. Either they're going to be nice or they're going to want to take us over. You ain't going to travel all that way to the backwoods of the universe to meet us and be like, hey guys, we needed some sugar. We're out of sun. Can we take yours?
Claimed they saw an object the size of half a football field. Let's take a look at that footage. Can we get those lights off, please?
Those are not aluminum rounds because aluminum rounds fall.
Oh boy, we gotta listen to soldiers talk about this.
Yeah.
And nobody shoots in a five gun section. And
you can hear it in their voice.
Shoots in a five gun section.
No, this is fucking weird.
You know, it's one of those things once again where you don't really know what it is. I think it's interesting that this is over a Marine base and seemingly this footage is taken by perhaps Marines. So I'm curious to see what the explanation for this one might be.
Military testing.
Anyways, let's get that light, lights on. The sighting was concealed until Jeremy Corbell received a call from somebody high up that said, quote, something happened and you should look into it, end quote. Immediately the source hung up. Despite these being only three of thousands of sightings, the federal US government officially hadn't had a program to investigate UFOs since 1969 when it shut down Project Blue Book. Project Blue Book was established after a rash of UFO sightings in 1947 gripped the nation. Its purpose was to determine whether flying saucers were a threat to national security. From 1947 until its conclusion, 12,618 sightings were reported. While most had an explanation, 701 of those sightings were still listed as unidentified. The final report found, one, no UFO reported, investigated, and evaluated by the Air Force has ever given any indication of threat to our national security. Two, there has been no evidence submitted to or discovered by the Air Force that sightings categorized as unidentified represent technological developments or principles beyond the range of present-day scientific knowledge. Three, there has been no evidence indicating that sightings categorized as unidentified are extraterrestrial vehicles. The National Archive states, quote, since Project Blue Book was closed, nothing has happened to indicate that the Air Force ought to resume investigating UFOs. Because of the considerable cost to the Air Force in the past and the tight funding Air Force needs today, there is no likelihood the Air Force will become involved with UFO investigation again, end quote. Despite sightings from civilians, military personnel, and even presidents for nearly half a century, this remained the government's position. Until the New York Times exposed the truth. On December 16th, 2017, the New York Times ran the headline, Glowing Auras and Black Money, the Pentagon's Mysterious UFO Program. In it, reporters Helene Cooper, Ralph Blumenthal, and Leslie Kane dropped a bombshell.
Yeah.
Not only had the government continued investigating UFOs, but $22 million was funneled to an organization called the Advanced Aerospace Threat Identification Program, also known as AATIP, created by Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid in 2007. This program was run out of the Pentagon by military intelligence official Lou Elizondo. In order to further conceal the program, UFOs received a new name. UAPs, Unidentified Anomalous Phenomena. AATIP collected documentation of UAP sightings from military personnel, particularly pilots, that described aircraft which appeared to move at an extremely high velocity with no means of propulsion, and ships that would hover with no apparent means of lift. This would require technology far beyond what is known to exist. And there were videos. Having known now that they have lied, and they have admitted that they lied.
Yeah.
Do you think it's possible that all the rumors of bodies being recovered at, say, Roswell, are true?
Yes.
I can't weigh in on that. I'd say no, but I don't know. You know, I wasn't there, man.
But if they said there weren't, but everyone, all the officials involved said there were.
I don't think anybody can, there's no conclusive stance on any of this. That's my point. I would also hope that in today's modern era, you know, let's bring another one of those fucking ships down. Let's get some more bodies on the ground. I want people out there.
I don't think we need to tempt,
I think we do.
Otherworldly war just because some dudes in suits don't want to show the photos.
I think we do. I think we do need to provoke a galactic war because I want to see those little gray fuckers dancing on TikTok. I want to see them out there.
Actually, I mean, I'm not going to lie. Getting killed by an alien would be pretty fucking cool.
It's a good way to go.
And honestly, this world deserves it. So, you know, if they were, you know what, maybe I'm with you. Let's just blow it all up. On November 14th, 2014, the USS Nimitz Carrier Strike Group was conducting drills. At about 2 p.m., two FA-18F Super Hornet fighter jets were ordered to stop their training maneuvers in order to take on a real-world task. As they approached, Commander David Fravor spotted one of the objects about 50 feet above the water. Let's take a look at this video. Lights off, please. So, yeah, I mean, that's obviously one of the more popular videos.
I remember seeing that one.
I will say that when they admitted that there were videos, I bet you there's better videos than this, but this feels like them just kind of like giving like a little like, hey,
oh, yeah,
here's the video. This is all we got.
Yeah.
Stop asking us. That's my take on this.
You think they're going to show you the video of the alien that they have cooking in the kitchen? No. But we just got to believe he's there, okay?
I do think it's a pretty conclusive and, you know, substantial video. But
you gotta get better cameras.
I also, from my understanding, this was this object was moving quite fast. So this
if I'm an alien, I'm zipping around the ocean. That's what I'm doing. They
cruising.
Got the right idea. Yeah. Cruising.
They probably got footage of Top Gun.
Yeah.
They probably came here and they're like, I want to meet Tom Cruise.
I want to meet Tom Cruise. My Ooh. Boy Zinu said he's great.
Assuming, of course, Tom Cruise is not an alien already. When asked for a comment for the article, Pentagon officials acknowledged the existence of the program, but insisted it had been shut down in 2012. Much like Project Blue Book, Pentagon spokesman Thomas Crossan said, quote, it was determined that there were other higher priority issues that merited funding, and it was in the best interest of the DOD to make a change, end quote. Belu Elizondo claimed the work continued with officials from the Navy and CIA. Growing frustrated by the intense secrecy, Elizondo resigned in protest on October 4th, 2017. In his resignation letter, Elizondo made clear there needed to be serious attention paid to, quote, the many accounts from the Navy and other services of unusual aerial systems interfering with military weapon platforms and displaying beyond next generation capabilities, end quote. Pressure began to mount on Congress for more oversight into these projects. In response, the Department of Defense established the UAP Task Force. The mission was to, quote, detect, analyze, and catalog UAPs that could potentially pose a threat to U.S. national security.
Hell yeah.
Before we move on
job.
Here,
I want that job.
Out, that's the second lie. That's the.
It's another lie from the U.S. government.
You writing anything there, like liar, liar, pants on fire, or? I would show us the videos.
I was just drawing little aliens. You know I like to doodle. I'm a doodler. That's how I learn things, by doodling.
Fair enough. On June 25th, 2021, the Office of the Director of National Intelligence released Preliminary Assessment Unidentified Aerial Phenomena. In the UAP Task Force's classification, incidents fell into five different categories: airborne clutter, natural atmospheric phenomena, USG or US industry developmental programs, foreign adversary systems, and a catch-all other bin. The Deputy Director of Naval Intelligence insisted that there was no recovered wreckage or any indication that the UAPs were of extraterrestrial origin. The report declared, quote, UAPs clearly pose a safety of flight issue and may pose a challenge to U.S. national security.
Just end a quote. Little bit.
Now, we're about to get into the corkboard here, but before we do that, do you have any idea of what this all means so far?
No.
Now that you know the gamut of lies.
I'm out until you show me a video of a little guy exiting a ship being like, "Wapak, ukuga," you know? I wanna see him.
All that to say, it's corkboard time. Let's get into those theories.
Yeah!
Theory one, this was the US government covering up experimental tech. Now.
I mean, yes.
You know, this is just another variant. They're covering something up, but what are they covering up?
I do believe 100% the government has shit we know not a damn thing about everywhere. Cities underground, where all the smart people live. You think they're dead. They're not. They're all underground, living in a society that we'll never know nothing about. It's like Atlantis. I ain't kidding, man. I don't believe shit the government tells me half the time. I need to be lied to. I do. It's true. But still, I don't want to be lied to.
Their own tech. Look at all of it.
That's a lot of tech.
That's right. At the height of the Cold War, the U.S. welcomed the theory that UFOs were of extraterrestrial origin as it helped cover up experimental tech they did not want their adversaries to know about. In 1955, reports of UFOs skyrocketed near a remote salt flat in the Mojave Desert. Seemingly overnight, an area had been cordoned off by the government. Despite the public being able to see the gate surrounding the base, the government denied its existence. Due to its designation on Atomic Energy Commission maps, people began calling it Area 51. It became a UFO legend.
Rings a bell.
You might have heard of it. It became a UFO legend, spawning countless theories about what may be going on there, from communication with extraterrestrials to reverse engineering recovered crafts. But when the government declassified documents on aerial surveillance programs, the truth came out. For decades, Area 51 was used to develop top secret planes and technology. But it wasn't just the United States with spy planes. From the German rockets in World War II to Chinese surveillance balloons, covert ships from all over the world have been mistaken for UFOs. The US even acquired a Soviet MiG-21, which they reverse engineered at Area 51. The 102 test flights they did in the MiG-21 eventually led to the creation, listen to this, of the Top Gun Fighter Pilot School.
Yeah!
In 1997, the New York Times ran the headline, CIA admits government lied about UFO sightings. In it, a CIA study revealed that, quote, in the darkest days of the Cold War, the military lied to the American public about the true nature of many unidentified flying objects in an effort to hide its growing fleets of spy planes, end quote. Today, Area 51 is still a military operating area, guarded by armed soldiers, buried motion sensors, and signs warning that deadly force is authorized.
It's so cool that people get to work there.
Well, they're just guarding tech. It's not like like they're guarding little aliens. That'd
But it's cool. Like if like someone's like, "Where do you work?"
How do we know they're not guarding aliens?
Oh, is that like
have
a like a
hookah bar? Has anyone been in there?
No, the Area 51, the one full of aliens.
What?
Yeah, heard of them.
That's crazy. Or there could still be aliens in there. They're just lying about it.
Exactly.
So, who knows? Theory two.
They're lying about it.
The UFOs are natural phenomena.
You're not even gonna ask me what I think of theory one?
No.
Oh, okay.
Theory do you two. Want? What do you think about theory one?
I think it's plausible.
Some of these unidentified flying objects may not be objects at all, but natural occurrences. While the government has used everything from pilots mistaking the planet Venus for an alien spaceship to temperature inversions to explain what was going on, one of the most common explanations for sightings of UFOs is St. Elmo's fire. This is a phenomenon where people see blue or purple balls of energy radiating off ships, planes, and other objects accompanied by the sound of buzzing. It occurs when an electrical field, usually around a rod-shaped object like an antenna, causes particles in the air to lose or gain electrons, creating luminous plasma that is easily seen in low light. Usually conditions are just right to experience this eerie sight right before a lightning storm, but that is nothing compared to the storm that has overtaken Washington, D.C.
Are you talking about the January 6th people?
No, that's a different kind of storm.
Oh, okay.
That storm is pretty easily identifiable, and you could see that by the people in jail. But what do you think about theory two?
Yep. I mean,
I thought you would like this one.
I mean, St. Elmo's fire is cool. I've always wanted to see like video of it, which I've never
seen.
Me too. I've read descriptions of it. I think like that video of them clocking that thing flying over the ocean.
That ain't St. Elmo's fire.
It's not a natural phenomenon.
Let's move on to theory three. And the storm that has overtaken Washington, D.C.
Okay.
You gotta stop
saying it like that.
The government is in possession of aliens. Boom! The headline, intelligence officials say U.S. has retrieved craft of non-human origin. Blared the front page of the debrief on June 5th, 2023. Decorated Afghanistan combat officer and veteran of both the National Geospatial Intelligence Agency and National Reconnaissance Office, David Grush, had filed a whistleblower complaint to Congress and the Intelligence Community Inspector. In it, he claimed that while he was working for the UAP task force, he obtained, quote, extensive classified information about deeply covert programs that possess retrieved intact and partially intact craft of non-human origin, whether extraterrestrial or unknown origin, end quote. During an interview with News Nation, he went even further, saying, quote, well, naturally, when you recover something that's either landed or crashed, sometimes you encounter dead pilots. And believe it or not, as fantastical as that sounds, it's true, end quote. These programs had been illegally hidden from Congress. In accordance with protocols, Grush had his statements
I want an alien.
By the Pentagon. However, Grush made clear that these non-human biologics may not be from outer space. He said, quote, I'm not saying this is 100% the case, but it could be that this is not necessarily extraterrestrial, and it's actually coming from a higher dimensional physical space that might be co-located right here.
That rich end dick. Quote. I love that.
That's
I like that.
Fucking wild.
Yeah, that's
multiverse.
So he's basically going string theory here. He's saying that there's another dimension and these people have like popped through like Doctor Strange.
That's cool.
I don't think so.
I love it.
No?
I mean,
you don't like?
I think it might be more likely that there's just the galaxy's huge and there's probably some other people or things out there.
Here's
one of my beefs, though,
okay?
I love it. Here's
this guy, so he's grilling and eating. He says, I'm a whistleblower.
Toot toot.
Toot toot. Hey, by the way, there were pilots.
Yes.
As there would be.
Yes.
Give us some fucking details.
But he can't.
Yes, he can. If he's already blowing the whistle, just say one thing. I'd be like, and by the way, they're gray. You know, give him something.
But he did say may or may, I mean.
He'd be like, Ridley nailed it.
He is dealing within the confines of what is legal according to Congress. So like certain things he can or can't say. And I think he knows, here's how far I could push it before I get whacked.
Yeah.
Not only did the US have crafts, but so
mysterious
did other
car accident
going as far back as Italy under Mussolini's reign. He believed it was dangerous for this to remain hidden not just from the public, but government officials, because it, quote, further inhibits the world populace to be prepared for an unexpected non-human intelligence contact scenario, end quote. Cool as fucking way to say, aliens may come. A non-human intelligence contact scenario. Fucking baller.
Yeah, that's
it is.
I like that a lot.
Such consequential allegations quickly made their way to Washington, D.C., where on July 26th, 2023, the House Oversight Committee's National Security Subcommittee called a hearing to explore rising concerns about UAPs and the lack of transparency in their reporting. Let's see what Grush said in his opening statement. Lights off, please.
My testimony is based on information I've been given by individuals with a long-standing track record of legitimacy and service to this country. many of whom also have shared compelling evidence in the form of photography, official documentation, and classified oral testimony to myself and many my various colleagues. I have taken every step I can to corroborate this evidence over a period of 4 years while I was with the UAP task force and do my due diligence on the individual sharing it. This is because of these steps, I believe strongly in the importance of bringing this information before you.
And furthermore, here we see Grush on public record again allege that non-human remains have been recovered. Let's get those slides back on.
You've stated that the government is in possession of potentially non-human spacecraft. Based on your experience and extensive conversations with experts, do you believe our government has made contact with intelligent extraterrestrials?
Something I can't discuss in public settings.
I do like that the congresswoman that asks
Love that.
Him if we made contact with extraterrestrials does it with like the delivery of like a mom that is very skeptical of what their child is saying.
Yeah, very much so.
He also seems pretty happy that he can't say anything.
Well, of course.
Well, he also doesn't want to get killed.
Yeah, that too.
Congress 100%. Calls two additional witnesses, Dave Fravor.
Look, it happens, mysterious car wrecks, falling out of a hotel room. It happens, people. Like, you start going down the rabbit hole like I have, and you... Like... And one dude being in his own suitcase dead. Like, come on now, you know what I mean?
The pilot who recounted witnessing the Tic Tac incident, and Ryan Graves, a former F-18 pilot with experiences of his own that had turned into an advocate for UAP research. To the congressman, Graves stated that pilots were not coming forward with their UAP encounters out of fear of professional repercussions. Their fear was, quote, compounded by recent government claims questioning the credibility of eyewitness testimony. End quote. Despite their silence, there were UAP sightings, quote, essentially where all Navy operations are being conducted across the world, end quote. Graves said that the most common sighting is of, quote, dark gray or black cubes inside of a clear sphere, end quote. Much like the following video released by the Navy in 2021. Let's take a look at that video. Lights off, please. It's quick. Huh? It was fast.
It's very fast. Is that a freeze frame of it there?
This is a freeze frame right here. You could see the cube. I mean, just imagine you're on whatever, Southwest Airlines sipping down a cocktail and you look out the window and you see that.
Though also, that is very out of focus, so it's...
It's incredibly out of focus and very fast.
It could be an actual object and you wouldn't even know because it's so out of focus that it's just...
Right.
The one thing that's nice about this is you could see it is taken from the inside of a military plane.
Yes, that's cool.
So it's not like just some dude that's like, hey!
Yeah.
It's somebody with, you know, actual accreditation.
Is this what they're doing up there? They're just taking out their cell phones while they're doing military stuff?
Well, if they're seeing something, they're like, hey, I gotta get, you know, video of that so no one thinks I'm crazy.
Yeah.
On the subject of how the hidden program...
I heard that, like, as a pilot in the military, you do not come down and say that you've seen aliens. Like, it's bad, if I'm not mistaken. I watched a documentary on it once. Matter of fact, I think it was around, you know, 2017, 2018, whenever, like, the videos and stuff started coming out. Like, pilots would come out saying, you just didn't say anything about it. Like, if you did, you was had. So.
Programs were funded. Grush confirmed money in the budget was being diverted from the purpose it was approved for. Representative Burchett asked Grush if he knew of anybody who has been murdered for trying to expose these secrets. Grush replied, quote, I directed people with that knowledge to the appropriate authorities, end quote. After the hearing, Defense Department spokeswoman Sue Goff gave a response with echoes of the past. She said investigators have not found, quote, any verifiable information to substantiate claims that any programs regarding the possession or reverse engineering of extraterrestrial materials have existed in the past or exist currently, end quote. And then, of course, this does not include those funny little Mexican aliens, which we have already mentioned.
They're the funniest
Very
aliens
funny.
I've ever seen.
We could probably put
guys.
A picture up of those right now.
I love them so much, and I love the little... I love the
funny little guys. Oh, wait. Yeah! Look at this guy just sitting there. His last words were,
They give him a little pillow to lay on.
Yeah, a nice little coffin.
That's the kind of bed I want, where it's like a divot.
Like in...
I've always wanted a divot bed.
In health
bed.
Or in death?
In life. In life. I want a divot bed.
Anyways, what do you think here?
I'll go tech. I'll go the most boring one.
Tech.
Like I think you mentioned, they don't want other potentially hostile nations to.
And that would make sense. I mean, it's an arms race. You know what I mean? Like, you want to be walking the tallest, carrying the biggest stick. You don't want someone copying your stick in the 3D printer. I get it. But I think it's a little bit of all of them, bro. I think that they're working on secret ships and stuff from alien ships that they are reverse engineering. And I think they have aliens helping them do it. Not like by choice, but by force. We don't know why aliens are here. They could be taking us over. They could just be like, hey, we need to borrow a little bit of sun. Hey, can we get like some water for our ship? We don't know why they're here. But that's what I believe.
Know what kind of tech we're working with.
But that doesn't really explain them lying about a UFO program and all that stuff a couple times over the past
years. Think they're just fuzzing the radar there.
Okay.
Well, like I said, I do believe in aliens. I just... Similar to ghosts, like, show me the fucking money, baby.
Well, you can't hear.
See, I believe in aliens, and whenever I say aliens, I don't automatically mean, you know, the little green men, the grays, and stuff like that. My idea is it could be. It very well could be. It could be lizard people. It could be people, things that look just like us, but, you know, different because their world's slightly different, whatever. But it could be as simple as just single-cell organisms, you know. Amoebas, algae, plankton, like that's all still a form of life, and it's alien life. I believe aliens are out there, bro. I do.
Because you'll get killed, apparently. So.
Well, in today's world, with everyone having cell phones, we'll get it. Just like one of these days, one of the billions of people on this planet will get a full-bodied apparition.
I mean, but people have gotten that. You just don't believe it's real.
Yeah, they haven't.
Well, that's
not with a good camera.
That's, I mean, they
not
have.
A decent
well,
one.
He doesn't believe that.
No, they haven't.
There's nothing you can do about that.
They haven't.
While the government continues to deny that UFOs are not of this planet, it is obvious
Ryan's never going to win that argument, no matter how hard he tries.
That the government is covering up the true nature of many UAPs. Despite the obvious threat to national security, the U.S. insists on classifying evidence which would provide answers. As more eyewitnesses and whistleblowers step into the light to demand disclosure, we may soon get an answer. But for now, whether or not we already have proof of extraterrestrials or extraterrestrial UFOs remains a mystery.
So we're not there yet.
We're not there yet.
I hope we get there.
Yeah, I really do hope. I kind of
hope
you're right. I kind of hope it's just experimental tech, because if I'm right, we're all going to die probably.
I hope it's little guys. I want little guys.
I think it's going to be very bad for all of us if it's real.
I mean, if their dumbasses crashed in New Mexico, then I'm not concerned.
Exactly.
I just feel like it's going to be bad news if this is real. So, although I do believe it is real, I hope it's not.
Okay. Well, it's been fun. I love aliens.
Then again, we're probably all going to end up killing each other with the tech. So, which one is it going to be? Aliens or, you know?
It's going to be ourselves.
World War III.
Well, this has been fun.
Or the sun.
I want to see that someone sawing off a little alien's head.
Let me rephrase.
I don't watch that kind of grisly stuff, but I would watch it of an alien. I want to see them.
It makes me feel like you do watch it, but that's not today's topic.
All right. I really enjoyed today's video. I love aliens. I love Bigfoot. I love the Loch Ness Monster. I love all the mysteries of the world. There's an innocence to it, man. I'm telling you, I love it. Tap into your imagination. Just let it run wild, man. I'm telling you, I really do. I love aliens. If you don't believe me, check out my store. Man, I got alien stuff, Bigfoot stuff, regular apparel. Just dropped some stuff for summer. For those of you who enjoy summer. All right. I really enjoyed today's video. If y'all enjoyed today's video as much as I did, please go down there. Hit that thumbs up. It really helps the channel grow. While you're down there going over, slap that subscribe button. Become part of the Bill for 1000 Nation. We do some crazy shit here. And if you want to know when that crazy shit happens, ding that bell. It might work for you. It might not. But But if it do, sir, jump in on one of my premieres, go over into the live chat and be like, hey, Bill, I just got dinged. And I'd be like, hells yeah, my friend. Leave a like and dip. That's all you got to do. As always, be good to one another. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye. Aliens are real. E.T. never phoned home. They're all around us. Lizard people live in the sewers in New York City. I'm telling you.